Hello, everybody. So, not too long ago, the developers of Dead by Daylight, the asymmetrical horror game, decided to do an anniversary stream in which they had a couple of announcements. But one of the most predominant announcement that I think is probably one of the most important is the fact that they're going to fundamentally change the game by adjusting 40 or so perks, with most of them being the more popular perks that they are probably going to either change drastically or nerf drastically. And this has led to a lot of conversations. Now, in a future video, I want to go over the top five perks that are going to be changed from both Killer and Survivor, but today I want to talk about a different concept, and that is the concept of crutch perks, which are these popular perks that people tend to flaunt about, and I want to talk about them in a more reasonable way, because Dead by Daylight and the fan base surrounding them tends to label these things and to consider it a bad thing and not really understand why. And so this video is to sort of attempt to diagnose and understand the problems and why calling things a thing is not really great, as well as what we should do when instead of really trying to insult each other by using the terms crutch perk. So, without further ado, let's get into the video. So what is a crutch, or what is a crutch perk in the specific context of Dead by Daylight? Well, a crutch is generally a form of support that people feel the need to use that is relied on heavily to retain normal movement. You know, just think of a stick that in a person who is old or a person who is disabled that might be using to get from point A to point B. They heavily need this, but crutches in the real life often refer to even things like drugs that are heavily needed to keep the pain away, per se. There is lots of ways crutch can be used, but in the form of video games, or in the form of crutch perks, it is generally used for perks in the game, or even killers, and maybe items, that are used that people feel they need, that they rely heavily on in order to do well. The thing with this is that it's used primarily as a negative lashing out at somebody for using perks that, quite frankly, are meta perks. And they use the term crutch perk in a way that's not exactly far from the truth, in a way to demean people to do that. Dead by Daylight is the only place I actually see the term crutch really used all too much when it comes to using particular perks or whatever, but it is not too dissimilar from other places and games and whatnot that you see the same type of people complain about things despite most people engaging in said things. And this is where we come up with the ultimate issue, because most people who bitch and moan about crutch perks are guilty of doing the same thing. If somebody's complaining about Dead Hard, they are probably using Ruin Undying. If somebody's complaining about Ruin Undying, they're probably using Decisive Strike. It's just one of those things that feels very ultimately weird to see in Dead by Daylight when people are just doing what people do normally in any video game, in any game, and that is playing to the meta. The meta is very key here, and people purporting to it is not really a bad thing, or may not be a bad thing, because it happens everywhere. It's only a bad thing when it's just the thing people do all the damn time, which is where the problem lies within when it comes to Dead by Daylight, and why this 40 perk change is a necessary change that needed to happen a year ago. Because of how the meta has not changed for years and years in this game, and thus creating a gigantic stagnation, and that allowed people to see the same shit over and over again with very, very different differentials. We had like a boon totem that was introduced that people use excessively, but that's the thing. They didn't change any of the popular perks. They only made a perk so abundantly strong that it would be used, and then they had to nerf it considerably, and it doesn't see nearly as much play as the other still popular perks. And that is the problem Dead by Daylight has, because in a lot of typical games, let's say League of Legends, for example, if a champion is seen as having an extraordinarily high win rate, people are going to abuse the shit out of that. It is either going to be giga banned from every sort of ranked match, or it's going to be used too much, and it's just going to be a boring, terrible time because people see that champion all the time. And unlike behavior, that champion tends to get changed relatively quickly if there is a high reason to do such a thing. This doesn't mean that League of Legends is perfectly balanced, per se. They have over 100 champions and then items and runes and whatever the case may be to balance, but if something becomes an outlier enough where you only see that thing either being banned or whatever, that is when, and you will see Riot change something about the game. But when you see Dead Hard, when you see Borrowed Time, when you see Ruin Pop, and all these other perks again and again and again on killers and or survivors, it creates a not nearly as fun experience than seeing diversity. Because the game would definitely be better if there was 20 meta perks than 6 meta perks. Erics, because that's what we have come down to. We have come down to having just a few perks that are decent and enough, and just too many perks that are just super good for too long. And that is why these changes that are upcoming are necessary. But I also want people to understand that if people use these things, that's not a bad thing. It's not a bad thing to use Dead Hard. It's annoying that people use it, but we shouldn't exactly be pointing the finger at that individual for using said perk when it's a good perk. You know, you're telling somebody, this is the equivalent. You're telling somebody that they shouldn't pick up their cane and use it to walk so that they can get a advantage they didn't have. Because that's what you're essentially saying when you're calling it a crutch perk and trying to insinuate it's bad. You're trying to say that people shouldn't do that. You know, and obviously it's not nearly as equivocal to somebody who wants to walk instead of limp, but if these perks feel powerful enough that people feel like they need it to play the game more properly, then I don't think that's a bad thing. And it's a bad thing for the developers to figure out if it becomes a stagnant thing, not the player's thing. Because sure, one could say, in a hypothetical dream world, yes, players can sing Kumbaya and decide not to use Dead Hard or not to use any gen regression perks or toolboxes or whatever the case may be. But the reality is, friends, nobody's going to do that. People want to win. If there is any remote of compatibility in a game, people are going to win, and they're going to use the best perks and ways to get to that end the most clearly. That is, unless we like only allow Dead by Daylight to have like goofy friends to play a survivor. That's the only time I ever like care to be lol funny and whatnot. But other than that, it's just an impossible thing to expect from people, which is why I just want people to respect what people bring and to just understand that's what it is until the developers actively change things. You know, and if you're upset that a perk like Dead Hard is going to be changed eventually, well, you shouldn't be. It's a perk that has been overly used for too long, and it needs to be changed. It is a change that needed to happen, like I said, years ago, because these few perks have been used ever since, really, their inception or the few buffs they've been getting. I mean, Decisive Strike has been nerfed like 19,000 times, and it's still viable. It's a perk that probably just needs a fundamental overhaul of how it works, and maybe even a name change, per se. But that is for a later video that I do want to make. So, if there's anything else anybody wants to say in the comments section of this video, please, if you have any disagreements, anything in whatever, or if you're just agreeing and enjoy the video, well, there you go. Make sure to leave a comment, throw down the like button and such, and hopefully I'll make another video. I'm glad to be back, and yeah, an interesting discussion. I'll talk to you later. Bye.